Members of different faith-based organizations are calling for a deliberate approach to conservation in communities around the oil refinery in Hoima District. They digested numerous issues that are threatening the natural environment, including abuse of herbicides, encroachment on wetlands, irresponsible disposal of plastics, and oil-induced developments.
The station is important in the Albertine region because when you look at the Albertine, we have had a lot of deforestation, just like any other place in Uganda. If you look at the statistics, over 90% of homes in Uganda use charcoal to cook their food. So as well as the population is increasing highly, it basically means the rate at which we are cutting trees is increasing.
Pastor Dorothy Olimi of Kabale Fellowship Church and John Bosco Wandera, a member of Kabale Catholic Church, say the area is currently suffering effects of deforestation. We are worried about the tree cover in Kabale, which has reduced. The forests were depleted. We do not have water and we no longer receive rain as often as we used to. There is no tree planting campaign. But what amuses me is that there seems to be a deforestation campaign. We have seen Bugoma forests that used to generate a lot of rain get depleted for sugarcane plantation. Others are cutting trees for charcoal production, which is affecting the climate. They have appealed to the government to provide free seedling to the community members for planting in order to mitigate the effects of the major oil projects under development in the neighboring Hoima, Bulisa, Nwoya, and Chikube districts. I request the government to think about the environment. We are capable of planting trees. Let them bring the seedlings to us. Through Green Faith Uganda, we need government to provide us with tree seedlings that will replace all the trees that are being cut. We also need the government to enforce a law that those who cut trees should practice reforestation. Edwin Mumbere, the coordinator for Green Faith International, has called upon the public to embrace tree planting to mitigate carbon from the atmosphere and save their agricultural production, which is highly threatened by unpredictable weather. Report by Ambrose Nwagaba Katoto for the news.